Devon. Where would we be without its stupidity, not forgetting the freaks, and more importantly, myself? Sure, we have our special Clingfield fanatics, and mostly not forgetting our lovely ladies. Drinking, slapping, shouting. Well, people, this is Devon, and this is Scott Vision. Really, what more can you expect from me? Yeah, I live in the Twilight Zone, but they do say mental health affects 1 in 4. Not in our case, more like 1 in 1. Still, this is my YouTube channel. Now let's enjoy life. Let's not forget the cops and the sirens and, oh, the fighting, the violence. Who knows what you can expect around the corner of West End. This is real Scott Vision.
Who's watching? Tell me.
Right, I made this video for one thing mostly, and more importantly, it's just to get a few bloody facts in there. Take my advice, if you ever get social workers bothering you, just avoid them. They are a pain in the backside. I've had nothing but sheer nuts today and I am bloody exhausted. Right, let me explain how my story works, shall we? Okay. Right. Honestly though, I'm with it, Mick here. What would we do without social workers? And let's be honest, right? There might be one good thing for them. When you need nappies for babies, they're there like that. Mind you, you can't be expected to buy nappies that cost £5 a time when you're on £45 benefits. You know, you've got to buy food and drink and everything else, you know. When you get £20, I think it is now, for children to give them everything they bloody will want. How the hell are you supposed to do that? You know, so then, you know, you always get your nappies off the social services, but of course, you know, a bit of breastfeeding and that's it, you're in trouble because, hey-ho, that could be neglect. It's touching a private part or something like that. This is the kind of stuff in the England society we've got to put up with social workers these days, and basically one of the reasons why I hate them. I mean, if they had super thick glasses, they might actually be able to see just off their nose and what actually goes on in front of them, which is mostly the problem because they can't bloody see what goes on in front of them. Instead, they've got to make up thick reports like, I've seen this happen. That's what I want to write about. Okay, so, you know, simple, you know, makes a lot of the silly little reports when some kid's falling down the stairs by accident, of course, in social services, hey, you push that kid, you know, and you get them bothering you, won't leave you alone, and then they talk about foster carers and everything like that. So, I just thought to myself about something. The next time you want to abandon your kid, keep your kid away from social service, I have a brilliant idea. Abandon them in a 24-hour shop. You know, if you actually abandon them in a 24-hour shop, you know, with like a Tesco from Morrison's, preferably Morrison's, you would get them fed, you would get them drinks, they get clothing, and they get free computer games just to muck around with, you know. What a brilliant place to junk a child. You know, I think it's a great idea myself. So, you know, it's one way of doing it, and just make sure you teach your children to say, my name's Smith Morrison's, you know, makes them think they're actually a big company's son or something like that, little son. They shouldn't bother you so much. But, you know, I mean, if we get a social worker involved, they ask us probably what our bit of sex life is, you know, what we actually do with our children, everything like this, you know. Or like, how many, you know, have you had several boyfriends in the last few years or something, or several few girlfriends? You know, and it's not on. We can't seem to get on with these social workers. I mean, you can't even probably do it doggy style that I'm looking over for a threesome, for Christ's sake. So, you know, what are we meant to do? We just cannot win or anything, you know. The other day, I had the story of two social workers in Guernsey. We're going to call them Hannah and Brian. Hello, if you're watching this, Hannah and Brian. I'm just going to be honest. Right. Two social workers, we're going to call these sons, Hannah and Brian, are walking down the road. So, as they walk down the road, there's this bloke, and there's a bloke fighting. One gets stabbed, the one that stabs him runs off, the bloke's on the floor, going, help me, I've been stabbed. So, okay, so they walk up to the bloke and think, right, I better help, because he's been stabbed. They looked over, instead, It never changed. There was, as always, all the person that did this needs help, you know, and walks up the road probably leaving the poor stabbed man on the floor. You know, doesn't that sound just like the social services these days? You just can't sing to win with them anymore. And then you've got their problem. When you're 16, you know, well, no, actually, we'll start from when you're a child. When you're a child and you're born, you get the social services on because you're born over and a bruise and you can't get rid of them. Like, your new best friends won't leave you alone, treating you to free mood and free things and this, free things and that, you know, so they get on with you. And, of course, they've got this little trick. I'm sure they've got this little trick. They go, take this one, take these ones from Guernsey, for instance. Look, we brought you a nice new mobile phone. If you come down to our offices and come back to your dear little foster home, we will give you a mobile phone as a reward because you're such a clever little girl. That's one way they do it. Or number two, if they're younger. Right, I'll make a deal with you, little boy or little girl. I will give you sweets as long as you can help me get my money for this week. You must say that your dad hit you and you get into a nice new home where you get loads and loads of goodies and toys and sweets all the time.
Really, Mr. Social Worker?
Yes, you will get all this.
Okay, my mum and dad hit me. Yeah, so now can I get the sweets? Okay, that's it, we'll get you the sweets. You find a new home.
So the poor person then is 16, is then moved from pillar to post, to pillar to post. Right. Okay, let's start off, so we'll start off with, I don't know, say, Cornwall. Then from Cornwall they get bored, you go to the capital of the moor, so they move you to Dorset, and then move you to somewhere else, I don't know, call it Devon this time, then back up to Scotland, then back down to the Channel Islands, back onto Guernsey, back onto Jersey, and back around. So after you're 16, you've finally been in 100 care homes, and God knows what else, you then go on and have a child. And you think, hallelujah, after 16 years, I finally got rid of the social services. But once that child's born,
hello, my dear, I heard you had a child.
Now let me see if we can help your child. And the vicious circle probably starts all over again. You know, so what the hell are we meant to do about social workers? They just cannot seem to keep out the way of us. And I just thought I was going to be honest and actually say a few things, home truths about social workers and how they work, you know. It's all right for them to pay £350 a week to someone who's in care, you know, a waste of taxpayers money. We pay like £350 for a MISPA, and guess what? The girl has been home for 4 months, and they want me to actually help them and go on their site and actually say, oh, no, it was 4 days. No, it wasn't like that, you know, oh, no. Just so they can save their backsides and lie as they always do, and hopefully get them, you know, hopefully get us in trouble, as always. So, you know, are we not allowed to talk out of our backside? Has it got to be the social worker to talk out of our backside? Well, I'm going to leave it as this. I think I've said enough. To be honest, social services are useless. They don't do nothing, and they just irritate us. You know, whatever you do, you've got to be careful. I mean, if you left a can of beer near a child, for instance, an empty can, for instance, they might say, oh, that little four-year-old drunk all the beer, you know, and that, and now he's being neglected. This is the kind of mentality we've got to deal with England with social services. And I just felt like, hey, I'm going to actually say something for a change. So, yeah, this is what I think of social services. And when there's poor people like me who get nothing, absolutely nothing, for looking after your people, you so-called foster care, when you're paying £350 here, £350 there, and I look after them for 3 months, and I get nothing. I spend £200 of my own money on looking after some person or something like that. I buy them clothes, I buy them food, I buy them drawing crayons, and I get nothing out of it. So I just thought, I'm going to make a video and just say a few things. So this is Mr. Social Workers. The next time you watch this, maybe you could get off your backside and actually do something that actually helps the community. Catch my breath. And not mess the poor people that actually want to do something around. You know, just accept it. People are normal. You guys aren't. You can't even see off your nose. Right, so one thing is my ranting and raving now. I just thought I'd do a video. And, yeah. Enjoy.